Hi, I'm Mandy Johnson with Health and Wellness, and today I'm going to go over a little bit with you on the areas of health and wellness. There are 8 different areas to health and wellness. And what does health and wellness really mean? It means things that keep us healthy and well, mentally, emotionally, physically, all the things in life that make us happy and feel good and internally healthy. There are lots of things that do that, but most of them all fall within 8 components. And those components we have listed on that wheel of health and wellness. So we're going to kind of talk about each one of these today and how we can do things to address these areas if we feel like it's an area that we'd like to improve on in our life. So first, I want to just go over what it means to have a personal health inventory or a personal health plan. The personal health inventory is just kind of inventorying those 8 components, finding out what they mean to you, if it's an area that you want to work on, or if it's an area that's very, very important to you that you do very well with. So first, let's talk about the circle a little bit and how it breaks down. In that circle, you will find in the middle is the most important thing. And it's about mindful awareness of yourself, being mindfully aware of how all these components play a role in who you are, how you feel, and how you interact with the world around you. Then we talk about those 8 components. Specific to you, what do they mean to you? Some of them may tie to another area. They may be intertwined. Really, none of them are standalone. They're all important in our lives. And then the outer circle talks about prevention and treatment. It also talks about complementary approaches to prevention and treatment, healthy ways to work on you in a healthcare sense. And then finally, the last circle is about community and how you engage with that community. It can be your family, it can be your friends, churches, people that you work with, but just how you engage with the world around you. So let's talk first about working the body. That's one of the main components of health and wellness. When we talk about that, we like to think about what does that mean to you, working the body. It can mean walking to the mailbox. It can mean riding your bike. It can mean walking up the stairs. Working the body doesn't mean that we have to do P90X or heavy, heavy exercise to be well and to do that work for your body and movement. So I would like you just to take a minute to think about what are things that you do that you enjoy that help you move the body. And we can kind of think outside the box on that if we need to. So gardening may be one area that we don't think about. When you're gardening, you get up and down off the ground and you may be lifting things. That's a type of movement. When we're swimming, we may really be doing it for hobby, but not thinking about it being working the body. So what are some things that you do that you consider working the body when you really think about all the movement you do in a day? It's important to think about the idea that when you lay, you're using less energy. When you stand, you're using a little bit more energy. When you're walking, you use even more. So the more movement, the healthier and the little bit more exercise you get. So that's kind of working the body and thinking about what it means overall to you and what it provides for you. Next, let's talk about power of the mind. What does that mean to you? It can mean positive thinking. Our mind is a very powerful part of our body. It controls a lot of our thinking, our movements, our actions. So what is power of the mind to you? There's no wrong answer on any of these, but it's just taking the time to explore that for yourself. It can be reading things that you are learning about in an educational sense. It can be learning a new skill. It can be all kinds of things, but really challenging the mind to become stronger. The next area is recharge. And I just want you to do the same with each one of these. Think about what recharge means to you. When a lot of us hear that word, we think about sleep and rest, right? Sometimes to recharge, it can be active things like running or spending time with family and friends. Recharge means what makes you feel good, what gives you energy and feel like you've been revived from being tired or maybe even in a bad mood. So there's lots of things you can do to recharge. You can do crafts, but it's important that we take the time to recharge, to rest, and to do things that bring us joy so that we can feel healthy and well and not tired and worn out. The next area that we can talk about is food and drink. I like to say that what we put in is what we get out. And what you eat is what you are a lot of times. Now, I personally can say I hold stock in Little Debbie, but I try really hard to manage the amount of sweets that I eat. That can be hard to do because those tend to be comfort foods for us. But what we put into our body plays a huge role on how we feel overall. It can help us feel more energized, or it can make us feel more lethargic and tired. And there's all kinds of ways that we can help improve that by having our own gardens, just paying attention to how much salt intake is in the food we eat, how much sugar is in the food that we eat, trying to get things that are maybe sugar-free. But there are all kinds of ways that we can be mindful of what we eat and drink, because they do play a role in how we feel and what's going on with us. The next area is personal development. And what does that mean? Personal development can, again, mean many things. Sometimes it can be connected to that power of the mind, but personal development means that you're challenging yourself to do something more developed. It can be in your workplace, learning a new skill to improve your work. It can be learning a new activity or a hobby, a craft. There's all kinds of ways to challenge ourselves, but that helps us to be motivated and to have a purpose in life, that we're actually having something that we're constantly developing within ourselves. That, again, can be through some of the things that fell in the other areas. It can be reading. You can learn a lot from reading, maybe another language even. So another area to think about is surroundings. This is an area that didn't always speak very loudly to me. It doesn't tend to be one of my bigger areas, but I have found that it plays a very important role once I was mindful of what I keep around me, the colors that make me happy, the sounds, the lights, smells. There are so many things that play a role in what is around us and how we feel. But until we take note of that and pay attention to it, we may not realize that they do have an effect on us. If there's a picture in the house that makes you sad, I bet you can find a picture to replace that makes you feel more happy and brings about more happy thoughts. So surrounding plays a bigger role once you really think about the things around you and how they make you feel. You can adapt those. Another area is spirit and soul. So sometimes this can be controversial. People say, I'm not religious. Spirit and soul is not necessarily religious. For some people, religion, church may play a huge component of who they are spiritually and within their soul. But there are things such as artistic qualities that a person have that make them more spiritual and grounded. Walking outside, connecting with the nature and the world around us can be very spiritual and soulful. Music can address your soul and your spirit. There's so many components, and we all have that spiritual soul. That's that individualism of who we are, how we were raised, and how we see things. So how do you tap into that? If we don't take time to step back and look at what that means to us, then we may be missing something that can really help us be a better person and be more confident in who we are. And then lastly, one of my favorites, the area of friends, family, and coworkers. Humans are meant to have other people in their lives. Many studies have shown that when people are isolated for long periods of time, they tend to have increased depression, sadness, loneliness. So how do we connect with people? It's okay to be an introvert and not like to have a lot of human contact, but in life we have to talk with people, either on the phone, in person, in parking lots, in stores. And how do we have healthy relationships? What does that mean? Does it mean I have to be around large groups of people? No, it doesn't. It means you can manage the amount of interaction you have with people, but knowing that you need to have a healthy amount of engagement in your life. And what are some ways you can do that? So we've talked about all these areas of health and wellness on the circle. And what I'd like to do now that I've asked you to give a little thought to each one and what they mean to you, I'd like to show you some examples of things that you can do that you might not have already thought of to engage with these areas in your life. If you don't have the book for health and wellness that we have for veterans, you can contact us at 501-257-3144 and we can mail one out to you and you can go through this workbook on your own. But within this workbook, we have a sheet that shows you things you can do in each area. So in power of the mind, you probably have things that you already do that help you be mindful. Positive thinking is one suggestion. Meditation, taking some quiet time to sit with yourself and just focus on the inner you. Deep breathing, having some breathing techniques, just sitting and being mindful of how your breath feels can be really beneficial. We also have mindfulness, and mindfulness means really just paying attention to everything going on around you. I think most people can say who have a driver's license have experienced driving from work to home or a regular driving path and realizing I just got home and I don't even really remember the drive. So being mindful means really being in the moment, noticing everything that's going on, whether you're eating that food at dinner table. We can get lost in conversation or watching TV, but really actually just being mindful of eating that dinner. That mindfulness really strengthens our mind to be aware and present in everything we do, even in conversation with a friend or in our jobs. Medication plays a huge role for some folks. Having the right medication can help your mind be more powerful if that's necessary for you and your provider works with you on that. Music. I find music in every section for me because I think it's very powerful. But music can help our mind relax and focus at times. And then reading is something also that can challenge that mind. So those are just some suggestions, if power of the mind is something you'd like to spend some time on, of activities that you can do to address that. Working the body. We shared a couple, from walking to the mailbox to taking the stairs instead of the elevator if that's available to you. Maybe you're chair bound. You can get elastic ropes if your arms are available and do movements or light weights from places like Walmart or sports stores that can also help you move. Maybe just the head, making sure you keep your range of motion left and right. You can do this while watching the TV from your couch or your bed or your chair at home. So working the body doesn't have to be those extreme exercises, but things like yoga, swimming, walking, riding the bike can all be very beneficial if that's available to you as well. Maybe you like riding horses or walking your dog. There's all kinds of things that you can do. Hiking to get out in the outdoors as well. Arkansas is a beautiful state if you live here to get out and walk around and see what's around you. Then on recharge, we said sleep is important. We know that everybody should be getting 7 to 8 hours of sleep. And while that doesn't always happen, maybe power naps are something that you can try. You can also make sure that you have alone time. Sometimes people say, well, I'm an extrovert. I like to be around people. But just like introverts, we also need to learn to spend some time alone with ourselves and be comfortable with that time alone. Maybe doing your favorite activity will help recharge you. Coloring, painting, writing, those can all be things that bring us joy and give us some peace and rest. Vacation time and just simple quiet time. Maybe treat yourself to your favorite ice cream or meal. Those are all things we can do to recharge. Food and drink. We hear all the time that food plays a very important role. One thing to do is to make sure you're getting balanced meals, not eating all carbs, all meat. There's a lot of different diets out there, but remember, healthy eating is not a diet. It's a change of lifestyle, something that you're mindful of every day with every meal throughout the day. That doesn't mean you can't have a treat every once in a while, but just thinking about eating a balanced meal, making sure you're getting your proteins, your vitamins that vegetables and fruits provide, really are important. Eating 3 solid meals a day. Sometimes people think, if I don't eat all day, I'm not taking any calories and I'm going to lose weight. Sometimes that can trick your body to making it thinking it's starving. So it actually lowers your metabolism. Eating 3 healthy, measured meals a day with small healthy snacks in between is a good way to take care of your body. Water, drinking lots of water. You may drink sodas or diet sodas, lots of tea, these energy drinks nowadays, but our body is mostly made up of water. So putting in what's already there is very healthy for it. Our body needs that water to stay healthy and well and replenished. gardening can help with that, right? We have a tendency to eat those things that we grow and put the effort into in a garden, as well as vitamins. Make sure you check with your provider before taking on any vitamins if you're on medications to make sure that that supplement is healthy for your combination of what's going on with you. You can even try sugar-free items. Now, moving on to personal development. You may have lots of things that you already do for personal development, or you may not have thought of them as that. But some other suggestions, along with the one of reading that we had earlier, is to learn a new language, learn a new skill, go to an education class. Most universities have classes that are free for folks 65 years of age and older to just keep themselves knowledgeable about new things and train their brain and challenge it. You can attend veteran groups just to have that social aspect and to challenge yourself on learning new ways of doing things. Community involvement is also a very good way to have some personal development. It can be very rewarding to give freely and volunteer within your community on what that gives back personally. Now let's talk about those surroundings. We talked about the lights, the smells, the sounds. Our experiences are really made up of our sensory system, how we see things, how we smell things, taste things, touch, how things felt to us. So all those sensory systems can be controlled by what we put in our community around us. Putting family photos that make us happy, or friend photos, or maybe adventures that you've taken in the past that you think about that make you really happy. Having those around your home, easily accessible in a photo album or on a frame on the wall. Maybe even make a room that's just filled with things that make you happy, those sights, sounds, smells, and tastes. The decorations and the colors, they can either be alerting or really calming, thinking about what you need most. The lighting and organization. Some people, when they have a messy space, cannot function. It's very hard for them to feel organized and in control when everything around them is awry. So just tidying up the space around you can help you feel a little bit better. So with the last two sections, spirit and soul, we talked about those, but let's talk about a few more things that you can do in those areas. You can get involved in volunteering within your communities on things that are important to you and you're passionate about. You can get involved in church organizations, community services within your communities. There's all kinds of ways that you can get engaged and give back. Reading, meditation, those mindfulness practices that we talked about. You can also just work on the outdoors, connecting with the birds and the trees and the sounds of the world around you. Art and self-expression. I talked about those being very important to expressing yourself. So that's another option. But feel free to explore many options in that area. So the last area is friends, family, and coworkers for us to just kind of review some ways that you can engage with those folks. Not everybody likes to be in person to engage with people, but that doesn't mean you still don't want some connection with other people. So some different ways that we can do that. Technology is great nowadays. We have our smartphones, where not only can we call people, but we can also FaceTime them back and forth. We can see them and talk to them from a distance. So if your families are far away, that's an option. There's now Facebook, applications like that, and media where we can contact family, we can message them back and forth through that media, and we can also do face-to-face videoing with them as well. So you can go out there and search different communication apps and see what out there works best for you. There's Snapchat, where you only just shoot pictures of each other if you're not a very verbal person. But some other things you can do to engage with your family, friends, or coworkers, play some board games. Those have gotten a little bit outdated these days with video games, but video games tend to disconnect us a little bit. Maybe sit around the table with a stack of cards, or a good old-fashioned Candyland, Sorry, or Trouble game. Remember that it's fun, though, and not to take it too seriously. You can also go on little family vacations. Vacations can be expensive, but they don't have to be. It can be a trip to the park or the river, somewhere close together. Maybe just randomly throwing a dart at a map close to you and going on a little ride for the day as a family with some conversation included. So there's all kinds of ways that you can engage with those around you. Another thought that people don't think about that tend to be introverts and don't like to be around people. Relationships don't just have to be human. Sometimes it's good to have a plant, helping it thrive, feeding it, watering it, giving it that sunlight that it needs. That can be a starting point for building a relationship with something. The next best thing is animals. Dogs, cats, turtles, fish, some people even like snakes. Whichever sounds like it appeals to you, it's good to start with an animal as well. They can be very personal and loyal to have a pet, to just crawl up in your lap. Dogs tend to have a good sense of when you're feeling down or need that extra of attention. So those are some ways that you can engage and have a relationship that aren't necessarily thought about. Also, getting involved in your community and hobby groups can be a way to communicate and engage. So I would just challenge you to think about these areas that we've talked about around the wheel of health and wellness. Think about that working in the body, power of the mind, spirit and soul, family, friends, and coworkers, food and drink, and personal development. What do these mean to you? When's the last time you've really thought about you and your mindfulness to these things, and what areas you want to explore for you for improving your health and wellness? If you'd like this book, you can simply call us again at 501-257-3144 and we can mail you a book, and you can follow along with these different little exercises with your own workbook. Sometimes on campus, we will have classes that are accessible that you can come in and work through this workbook with your peers. And we'll keep that updated on our Facebook page of when those classes are available. Thank you, and I hope you have a healthy and well day.